Good day. Today we'll talk about POCT or point of care testing. So we'll discuss. We'll talk about the what is point of care testing. Examples of POCT device. Another is the advantages and disadvantages of POCT. So point of care testing can be defined most simply as laboratory procedures performed near the patient. And it is predominantly performed by non-laboratorian. The most commonly used POCT device is the portable whole blood glucose meter. And regarding point of care testing, it is also known as alternate site testing, ancillary testing, bedside testing, decentralized testing, near patient testing, and patient focused testing. So for point of care testing, so for example, if the patient is in 401, room 401, then usually diba the main clinical laboratory kaya na siya sa ground floor. Okay. So 401, so you don't need to send a sample from 401 to the main laboratory. That's for POCT. Okay. Because you can perform the testing near the patient. Okay, so or bedside. Okay, so that's for point of care testing. Now, for point of care testing, it's predominantly performed by non-laboratorian. So, for example, nurse trained about POCT, they can perform the test. Also for physicians, okay, so no need na to ask you the med tech to perform this type of test. Okay, so for example, testing or determination of glucose concentration using blood glucose meter. Okay, so ma-perform na siya by non-laboratorian. Okay, non-laboratorian staff. Okay, so that's for POCT. Next, what are the advantages of POCT? So, to physicians, improvement in turnaround time for lab results and have better and more immediate patient care. Okay, so for POCT, well, first advantage is short turnaround time. And since there's short turnaround time, the physician can diagnose, okay, the patient immediately. Okay, so for example, troponin. Okay, so troponin is used to diagnose heart attack or acute myocardial infarction. Troponin T and troponin I. So for immediate diagnosis, instead of collecting blood through venipuncture and send that sample or transport that sample to the laboratory and wait for about 15 minutes, you can perform POCT or point of care testing for troponin I so that the doctor can diagnose the patient immediately instead of doing the traditional testing. Okay, so that's for POCT, advantage to the physicians. To patients, it is patient-focused system. Okay, so the patient, kaya pwede ganin siya mo, maka-witness siya during the testing, okay, so during blood collection, and in the determination of the result or in the obtaining of the result. Okay, so for example, if it is positive for high levels of troponin, usually for POCT it's not or POCT nga non-instrument based, it is usually semi-quantitative. It's not quantitative, it's semi-quantitative. Okay, next is it's less traumatic because it's easy to collect blood using finger puncture or finger stick puncture. The problem with that is finger stick puncture is more painful siya compared sa venipuncture. Okay, if ako ang patient, mas preferred na kong i-veni ko compared sa pag finger stick puncture. Okay, or finger puncture. Okay, so that's the second advantage. Next is improved convenience, or it's more convenient to the patient and less blood withdrawn. Okay, so for example, for venipuncture, you need to collect at least 2 ml of blood. But for POCT, dili kaabot 1 ml. Okay, so that's four advantages of POCT. So what are the disadvantages of POCT? So the major drawback is the cost per test. Okay, so it's not cheap because we'll buy it, diba? Buy box siya ang kit, but separate magud ang kada test kani, like one setup for this test, another setup for this test. And like sa traditional testing, we're going to buy, for example, if you're going to buy reagent for glucose, usually it's in hundreds. Okay, so per batch or per container, that container is good for 100 tests or 500 tests. Okay, so when you buy in bulk manggood, the cost per test will go down. Okay, so that's for POCT. Next, POCT analyzer tend to have higher disposable and reagent cost than traditional laboratory system. Okay, and it's difficult to maintain quality control, especially for non-instrument based POCT devices or POCT system. Okay, so we'll discuss later what is non-instrument based and instrument based POCT. So regarding QC, you cannot perform QC for you can perform per test quality control because it's incorporated in each test kit, but regarding LJ chart, you cannot draw or make an LJ chart for non-instrument-based QC system. Non-instrument-based POCT system. Okay, because the control, okay, for test kit, diba, naman na siya seeing apart. Okay, so for example, if this is the test kit, okay, this is the sample well. And this is the, for example, test 1 and test 2, then you have control. So if it is positive, for example lang, there's one line in the test 1 region and another line for the C region or the control. If no line siya for the control, then that test is invalid. So you need to have a line in this portion or in this region for control so that the test will be acceptable. Okay, so without that control line, that test or that procedure is not acceptable. Okay, so you can perform QC in non-instrument based POCT system, but you cannot make an LJ chart or Levi-Jennings chart because for this type of QC, it is qualitative or semi-quantitative. For LJ chart, we need the quantity manggood or the exact concentration. Okay, so that's why it's difficult to maintain quality control for BOCT. Next, proper integration of data into the patient's medical record. Okay, so for POCT, the problem is, unlike the traditional testing or laboratory setting or laboratory testing, diba, after determination of the concentration of the sample using a machine, automatic that machine will incorporate their result to the medical record system. Okay, dili siya inan as a POCT. Next, for patient with poor peripheral circulation because of shock or hypovolemia. So what is hypovolemia? Hypovolemia is the decrease in blood volume. Okay, so usually if the person is hypovolemic, that person is also hypotensive. Okay, meaning decreased blood pressure. So if the person has hypotension, okay, ayang body is less siya og blood flow. So less blood flow to the organs. Okay, so same with for hypotension, you have less blood flow to the, okay, for example, sa hand, so less blood flow. So finger stick sample are difficult to obtain, are often contaminated with interstitial fluid. So that's another disadvantage of POCT. Next, examples of non-instrument-based POCT system. So example is beta-HCG. So this is for pregnancy test. Okay. So diba ang pregnancy test, no need na to use a machine to determine the concentration of HCG. But it's semi-quantitative. Okay. Narakay, di magani siya matawag ng semi-quantitative, but na siya, for example, cut-off for it to be positive. Okay. So that's for HCG. So no need na for a machine or instrument. That's why it's non-instrument based POCT system. Another is the test kit for drugs of abuse. Example, you have meth, amphetamine, or shabu, and tetrahydrocannabinol, which is a metabolite of marijuana. Okay. So regarding meth and marijuana, diba, for meth, it is when the upper siya, but for marijuana, pang pa down siya, downer siya. Okay, so that's for what do you call this, meth and THC, and you can use a test kit, okay, to determine if the patient is positive for meth and THC. Okay. Next is cardiac markers, so for example, troponin and CKMB. So these substances are used as cardiac marker, meaning if the patient has high levels of troponin and CKMB, usually the patient has acute myocardial infarction, okay, or heart attack. Next is urinalysis, the chemical strip. Okay, that's an example of non-instrument-based POCT system. Next is occult blood testing and also glucose. So glucose meter is the most commonly used POCT device. Okay, so let's go back to drugs. Okay, so diba ang common you have meth or shabu and THC. Okay, so different sila. Ang meth kay diba ang mood ni mo kay pang active kay ka. So THC di ka active. Okay, so what if imo siya i-combine na ma-joker gi kagad. Okay. So, same na siya if you drink alcohol, you mix alcohol, for example, no, you mix alcohol with an energy drink, okay, grabe ang effect. It's because nai substance nga pang pa-up and naisa pang pa-down, okay? So, ay mo ang brain ka, ma-confuse siya, which direction man ang i-follow, okay? So, ala lang. So, you should not, okay, not try, should not try ang imong pag use og sini marijuana or shabu because those things or substances are addictive. Okay, so that's for non-instrument based POCT system. Next is instrument-based POCT system. So example, you have Vision by Abbott and Hemochron. So this one, Vision by Abbott, you can it can perform different clinical chemistry tests. Okay, and it's a small machine that you can carry to the room of the patient. Then for Hemochron, okay, this is Hemochron. So it is usually used for APTT and prothrombin time, activated partial thromboplastin time. So it's a small device. Okay, so you can carry this to the room of the patient. So, you know, hand man siya sa medtech. So small lang kaayo ang Hemochron. Another is you have the non-invasive POCT system. So you have the pulse oximeter. So this is an example of pulse oximeter. So it can give you the pulse rate and oxygen saturation. So usually, okay, so if your goal in life is to be a physician, a licensed physician, okay, so during fourth year in your medical school or ansana, kana sa medicine, okay, so fourth year med, so during your internship, So you're required to bring pulse oximeter almost every day ganyan na siya. Okay? You need to bring pulse oximeter because it's needed, okay? For easy checking of pulse rate and also the saturation, oxygen saturation. Okay? So these are examples of POCT instruments. Okay? So I think that's all for about POCT. So thank you and God bless.